It's awesome to be here. So actually, Grace, you did really well. So my name is Mikko-Jussi Laakso, and I'm from Finland. So I have background of course, I'm a math teacher. So I used to be a math teacher as well. But I have 20 years of background of developing the education system as a whole through research. But in the end, I have to say, we are building the community of change. That's the goal. Community of teachers who are actually changing the whole education system in Finland. So actually we are building, I would like to say, that take the next step, the global community of change. And we want, of course, we want everybody involved. So where I come from? I come from the University of Turku. And I'm the director of Center for Learning Analytics. And many times in Finland, we are actually the bridge between the theory and the practice, because we really want to know what is going on in the field. And then we build those kind of solutions with the teachers who really flies and works in the real life of us. Okay, that's this kind of short introduction. And then, of course, today what we'll go through, of course, I will tell you a little bit more my background. And then shortly about the Finnish education system. And then I will tell you the teachers-to-teachers initiative. What that means, that's the biggest thing in Finland right now, how we change the community. And then I will mainly focus this first to ninth grade approach. Relieve a little bit about the secondary approach, because we work from preschool to university. So today, unfortunately, I can only focus on some of those, and I picked the focus area. But before we start anything, normally when I'm having a keynote and how I started, so the next slide gives you some instructions, but please don't act before I say so. Okay, I call this academic speak dating. Rule number one, the person who you don't know, it doesn't sit next to you. So I want to see movement. You need to find a person who you don't know. For 30 seconds, introduce yourself, and then vice versa. And I want that then for a couple of minutes, you will talk about what you want out of this day, and for example, what learning analytics means to you, and how you could collaborate in near future, not in 5 years, in near future. But please stand up, find your person who you don't know, and go. And now, I will ask you a question. What just happened? And you know, I mean, I give you a task. And the thing is that that's one of the things, because I really believe that when we get the learners engaged with each other, how we can promote that into classroom, because now I can say we can have that in real classrooms, without actually saying so, it will be instant. We can achieve this with your kids as well. And you don't need to do anything that much, little bit, of course. Because this kind of collaboration is really important when we are learning, helping each other, being a coach or something like that. Okay, little bit knowledge about Finland, Northern Europe. So in the map, we would be somewhere here, maybe here. Down there, but North Europe, Russia, Sweden, Norway, Estonia are the neighboring countries, and this actually I come from the town of Turku. Capital is Helsinki, 4 million people right now, and you don't know, not that many. In my city, 180,000 or something like that. So for many people, it's called village. So, and then, of course, we have about 10 universities with a couple of campuses, and then we have 20 polytechnics. And then you might know, I mean, the main part, of course, is that Santa Claus lives in Rovaniemi. So if you didn't know that the authority lives in North Pole, no, it lives in Rovaniemi. And that's a big business to Finland. So, of course, then we have Angry Birds, Nokia, Supercell, couple of Formula One drivers, and then Northern Lights, snow, reindeers. So during right now, many people go to Finland to see reindeer, snow, Northern Lights, and Santa Claus. Okay, that's short introduction to Finland. Then the big question, because you will anyway ask from me, why the Finnish education system is so good? And one of the things that I have to say that this is in here is basic education. I mean, 9 to 10 years, of course, pre-primary education included. And then the academic track, the high school, we call it high school, or vocational. But the main point in here, I mean, then university. But the main point is that we don't have dead ends. So whatever you choose in here, you can either end up being whatever. So we don't have dead ends. And then, of course, there are a lot of factors involved, more than 200. But I picked some of those. If you would pick the top 10 list of professions in Finland, teacher would be there. It's really, I highly appreciate it. And then in the same time, from the salary point of view, it's not in the top 10, it's a little bit less than middle salary. And then every teacher, if you want to be a qualified teacher in Finland, 5-year master degree, 3 plus 3 bachelor and 2 for master, so 3 plus 2, everybody, if you need to be qualified. And then, of course, almost free system. In high school, you need to buy your books, and in university level. But then it's maybe the most important part that I call it, in the Finnish system, trust. We trust all the players who are, and that's why, for example, teachers are fully autonomous. What that means in practice, if this would be my class, I close the door, then I can do whatever I want. Even the principal is coming inside, go away. No, of course, nicely, but I know what to do. Basically, I mean how we educate our new teachers. We follow a little bit how we educate our medical doctors. A lot of practical training, a lot of support from the experienced guide, sharing practice, reflection, and go on. So that's one of the things behind it. Okay. Then we go to the Center for Learning Analytics. Here you can see that we are doing a lot of different things, but this is the main thing, that transform the society by maximizing the quality of teaching and learning evidence-based. So I have always said that I'm the guy who wants to change the world through evidences. That whatever we are doing, if we are changing some kind of component, how we measure the effect, can we measure the effect, what kind of proper instruments we are using while we are doing the research. And of course, to what kind of fields, of course, we do automatic assessment, AI, visualization, gamification, big data, and then of course, actually, we are developing one learning environment in Finland, which is right now the top one thing in Finland, which comes to the digital learning. And it's called, globally, it's called Eduten. And the thing is that, now you might ask, what the heck is in this picture? This is actually the starting point of the Teachers to Teachers initiative. When we started this 12 years ago, or actually now 13 years ago, first we developed something for the university education. We did have a tens of teachers, we were doing evidence-based day one. We were designing everything for the teacher. Because in the end, I have to say, there is only one question. If we can save together some time for us by co-creating and co-designing some new amazing things with really flies in the field, then we can really us engage. I mean, me being as a teacher. There is only really end one question. So this was the situation in Finland in 2009-2010. We developed evidence-based, some university things, courses, utilizing automatic assessment, inferior feedback. But the main thing, we did it with the teachers. And let's see the current situation. This is the crazy thing. That right now, in Finland, we have more than 8,000 teachers in the network. So how we were able to get there? So we co-created, co-designed it. So we didn't, because I have, of course, educational and engineering background, so we didn't go to our boxes in some corner of the house. No, no, we went to the field. Because, of course, I have a lot of teachers in my team. We went to the field every week. What do you need? What is really feasible? And of course, what I'm going to present here today, it's the digital learning path in math and computational thinking, but this is math conference, so let's focus a little bit more on that, because it's continuous. Why this is messing up my, I don't know. Math, so it's a continuum from primary, pre-primary to university. And we get a lot of data on the way. But the main thing is, still, we are saving time for you, and we can evidence-based say that it improves the student outcome. But this is the whole idea, the community of change. It took 7-8 years how we calculate. It took a lot of progress, working a lot of with teachers. But right now, it's the biggest force in Finland. In practice, it means that we have statistics, that every year we doubled up. When we started it, bam, even this is doubling up. Bam, 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 bam. And now, you know. And that's the thing, that the best part of this is still to see the kid excitement and teacher excitement when I can be part of this. Okay. Yeah, I said all of this. 12 years, most used, scientifically proven impact to learning. Because we know, because I'm a math teacher, we should never forget, there are no free lunches to learn. If you want to really learn, 95% of the, it's really hard work. And 5% is the talent side, especially in math. If you don't have your basic foundation Lego blocks right, then it's quite hard to learn new things. But how to do this in practice? That how we, because we have these mobile devices, tablets and so on, everything. How we can get, I mean, how we can steal those kids' time to focus on maths or languages or STEM or whatsoever, what we are now doing and in Finland. How we can do it? Because, of course, hard work can be sometimes this way. I could watch this video for 5 minutes. We were so lucky to get this on video. I will tell you, normal classroom, unfortunately this is Saturday, so in Friday, this would happen right now in thousands of classrooms in Finland. Once in a week, they will go to this kind of classroom with interactive exercises, getting immediate feedback, automatic assessment, and this is the reaction from one awesome pupil that he got something right. There is two main things. Yes, I got it right. And what happens after that? What is the next one? The snowball keeps going on. They are collecting trophies and points. And compared to traditional thing, they are doing 6 to 8 time works in the same time. 6 to 8 time. A lot of drilling, a lot of problem solving and so on. But a lot of drilling, getting Lego blocks right. And then problem solving, a more challenging exercise. We got this on video. Come on. I never believed that we got this intuitive reaction from classroom on video. Because of course I could talk about theory a lot, why this is working. But I know we are teachers mainly. I want to go into practice. So how we can do it, how you could do it, how we could collaborate. So basic concept, once in a week, this is from Lithuania. Classroom, once in a week they will go to the classroom, either with laptops or tablets or some devices. But for you as a teacher, what you need to do? Log in, click one button, and that's it. Because the content and the exercises are made over the last 12 years with the Finnish teachers, supporting the things what you should teach right now in your classroom. So it's not extra. It's the things what you should do anyway. Ready-made from the Finland, from the Finnish teachers. Developed over 12 years, last year. I don't go to the discussion about the screen time, quality screen time and what that means. I only will say that there was a research with 5th and 6th graders, and it outcome was that those kids who are spending less than 2 hours in a day, whatever screens, will get more better performance in school compared to those kids who are using more than 3 hours. I mean, including the free time. So what that means in the basic concept of the school, maybe right now between 1 and 2 hours in a day, that's a maximum, not for the full day. If somebody comes to me to tell you that we should do everything electronically, I said, go away. It's not best learning performance is achieved by combining different kind of approaches. And for example, what we really do it here for the teacher, 45 minutes in a week, we focus on those kind of things in which the educational technology is really good for, which free up some time for the other lesson, which is more human guidance or that kind of help is needed. But then, of course, I'm a scientist and I want how we can really save time in many ways for the teacher. So in practice, I really don't in the details in these functionalities because there are so many and there are so many different kind of approaches. But basically it's game-based. Yeah, this kind of driving a car and selecting, there is a question, 18 plus 10, then you select the gate, which lane you drive into. That's one exercise type. We have the template, we have more than 100. But the main thing, it's a huge variation. But we don't forget the basic ones. And for example, mental calculation. Adaptive exercise type, you put your headphones on, and based on your knowledge, you will get here, for example, who can do this? 14 times 8 divided by 2. And these can keep going, and then you get immediate feedback. What did you hear? It's more than yes and no. I mean that after you play, you will hear, you will respond, and then you can see what did you hear. And you can hear it again. Oh, this was 3 plus 4. So, and of course, visualization. So a lot of how we can help with the immediate feedback to make the learning happen. It's not just saying yes and no. Yes, it was correct. No, it was incorrect. But still, one part is only the math performance. that they will improve their skills. Because I like much more to which kind of direction we are going. How we can build the self-confidence, how we can build the resilience, I mean bouncing back from errors. And that's the most amazing thing. What happened when we started this? This will start to happen in your classroom. Oh, it's okay to make mistakes. Oh, where are you? Can I help you? This will start to happen in your classroom. Because actually the thing is that we actually reduce the stress, because this is not really, even it's in the end doing a lot of things, 300 to 400 in one lesson. It's really doing a lot, getting immediate feedback. We know a lot about more, but it's much stress-free. It's okay to make mistakes. For example, in this car game, you have 5 lives. If you make mistake, you have 4 lives less. Let continue. Oh, where are you? Can I help you? You know. Oh, by the way, this will start happening. And then, another really important thing is how we can support differentiation. I mean, I will say it again. I don't say it generally. How we can support differentiation with your school sizes, class sizes. That, let's say you have 40 students, you have 35 students. We have built with the Finnish teachers those mechanisms. How you can really do differentiation with big school class sizes. I mean, if we would have a personal teacher for everyone, that would be easy, you know, to train it, but we don't. So then we have built this kind of scheme that for the low achievers we built that it automatically detects that, but it's a teacher decision. Do you put the pupil in the low achievers? We call it warm-up exercises. Or if you are high performance, we call them bonus exercises. But for pupils, it's the same. It's the next exercise. They don't know. Do they belong? And then, of course, teacher gets a lot of data. And this is really what I'm really proud of, because I'm really proud of our teachers from Finland. How we do this, how we, this is, for example, let's say big language, or let's say big maths. Let's say big fourth grade maths. How we develop those lessons? First of all, several of my team members went to real life, working with real teachers, and getting feedback every week. And then the initial version is ready. And then this kind of how the community can develop the material. So it's a continuum, and it has been going on for years in Finland. When we renew our curriculum, like what we did in 2016, then we adjust it really quickly. Let's forget about this thing. I will show you concrete things that I will say only a lot of things that we have a lot of data, so we can do personalized learning, we can do personalized feedback. Through machine learning and AI, learner profiling, and so on. But I want to show the evidences and what that means in practice for you, the outcomes of this. First, the evidences. We have done this 10-week setup, 12-week setup, 2-year setup, in this kind of things that we first pre-test some knowledge, maths, language, or this kind of mindset thing. Then we have a treatment group who utilize only, remember, only once in a week. Once in a week, replacing one lesson. And then the other group is following a traditional thing. And then post-test. And I picked for this presentation just some of the outcomes from the different experiments. And this actually, I picked from third grade from Lithuania. So this is not Finland. This is Lithuania, because this is the, I have been all around the world. This is a global thing. We used proper instruments, And you know, you can compare it how much 6% means in some kind of PISA test or whatsoever. But we use a proper instrument. 15 weeks, 12% in math performance. 11% in absolute scale. 11% in arithmetic fluency. But then, if we compare it, that, of course, I mean, whatever you do, you learn in the control group as well. This is 39% more or 45% more learning compared to treatment control group, which is amazing. This was 15 weeks. Oh, look at this. Children chose to work more than 50% extra at home. Because in Finland, we have maybe 10 to 15 minutes homework in a day, in lower grades. They chose to work a lot more. And this actually, every of this is coming back as a saving time for you. And then fix 5 or 6 grades, or now 10th grade, permanent increase of grade by 1, which means 15 to 20% in practice. 2 years set up, permanent for everybody, low achievers, middle achievers, and high achievers, because we support differentiation. So what that means in practice, improve student performance in standardized tests like TIMSS and PISA. Even I have to say that I don't like this really global test, because I would say that we should go for the test-free kind of things, that we can get to actually the other thing. But that's the life. We need to adapt. That's the situation. TIMSS is coming. And by the way, I forgot, 75% less mistakes. And it's okay to make mistakes. But as I promised, when we dig into the data, how we can help you. So this is one thing that will save a lot of time for you. And this is come from the research. I have hidden the student's name. This is the typical misconception, this keeps on going. Typical misconception on primary school maths, for example. And whenever you see green, I mean like this student, green, 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 green. Ah, don't worry, everything is going okay. With this student, oh, red, red, orange. So what they mean, I like the orange most, I will come back to the one, but red means that through the evidences, you have a learning problem. Actually, one means that two is still somewhere, but if it drops to one, then you have some learning difficulty. How we do normally these things globally? We give them a pen and paper test. So of course, we did an experiment in which they did these exercises, we get a lot of data, they did the pen and paper test. And that's the exact match right now. So for you, you don't know, need to guess anymore. This is evidence that if there are red ones or the best one, the orange one, there might be something there or the orange one, that we can prevent a problem come a problem. We can do some intervention, and then of course we are doing different things. But nobody left out of this equation. This is the whole class. And what you need to do? Nothing. No grading. This is automatic. And of course the evidence is here. Just want to know, because I'm the scientist, I want to build everything on evidences. The blue one is the paper test, and the light blue one is the system. So we can, it's an exact match. If this is showing, the pen and paper would show as well. What's the time? Every time, lost. How much I have time? Okay, that's awesome. We will recap this, but let's go to the secondary education. I mean, what I mean secondary education in Finland. it's grades 10, 11, 12. Because we have what we called, of course, we could go lower secondary grades 7, 8, and 9, and primary 1 to 6. But right now, really the biggest problem in Finland is that we would need 15,000 IT or science specialists right now in Finland. There is a shortage of 15,000 workers in IT and not science right now. If you know somebody, send it to Finland, they will get work. That's a cruel situation. But then, when I think it from the nationwide approach, how we can change the situation, that how we can make, because we are working with STEM and you know, how we can make this kind of thing more attractive. And of course, right now, I mean, the maths conference, how we can make more maths more attractive. And of course, what we did in Finland. I have said this to many, 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 many people. Unfortunately, the experience, what they are getting while they are learning maths or learning many other subjects, it's too many times that teachers are pointing out, you didn't get this right, you didn't get that right, you didn't get that right, and I want to turn the cup upside down. I mean, what we are doing in here. Let's go a little bit back. Lot of positive feedback. I got something right. And then you will see the snowball effect. And then you will see what happened in the first 3 minutes in here. A lot of the discussion. And you don't need to do anything. Because, for example, it was awesome feedback. Because, of course, I go still a lot of in the field. One of the teachers came back to me that, and she said to me that, Mikko, I didn't never believe this. But kids can do this on the Friday afternoon. They are focusing, they are silent. Because, of course, in Finland, Friday afternoon is the last school day. And I said that, yeah, that's, by the way, a good way of focusing, that when we get something right with the teacher, create something, then it really helps the everyday life of the teacher. Yeah, that was a little bit touching moment as well for me on that day. Or I will tell you not a nice special education. Not a city. And actually that was told by one of my team members, that specialized teacher. So those who are really struggling. That for the next training came that I have tried everything. But you just made a couple of things, and now those guys are doing focusing on the things. This is why I do this work. This is, did see the kids' excitement. This is what the teachers are doing. This is why I do this work. Change the world. Okay. So now, let's get back to our problem. How we can increase the number of students who select advanced maths in Finland? Because in Finland you can select basic or advanced. And they have one joint course in the beginning of the grade 10. And then they will make the selection. And I said that, okay, from the nationwide approach, let's focus short term for this first course, but in the long run, let's build something else. And we started this about year and a half ago. We just replaced, one to two, it depends. There were 800 students in this experiment. And we just replaced one, in some schools two, lesson per week. It means that they have 45 minutes, because they have 75 minutes lesson in the high school. And of course, half of those, control group, half of those, treatment groups. And when we provide, you got something right. 15% more selected advanced maths. You got something right. Oh, there was a diagnosis that you are recapping. You need to recap, but you got something right. The self-confidence and the mindset of the student changed. Yes, I can do this. And this is a huge, if you think about it nationwide. 15% more select advanced maths. Just by doing something 6 weeks. And now we are changing the whole attitude from the preschool. It will be changed a big scale. I mean, that's the longer approach. Now we did a shorter one. But I will skip that. That's the learning analytics, because I want to support the thing. But let's go to conclusion. The last one. That's the thing. We have tools, we have whatsoever. The last one is the main one. How to build a community. With practical hands-on approach to real life. That we have co-designed and co-created with the teacher. And then it's through the teachers it will go and snowball effect as well. Because it will help you everyday life. But in that sense, in general, it's all about active learning, collaboration, getting immediate feedback, get the discussion going on. And of course, it's nice to improve math skills, evidences. But I like much more resilience, self-confidence, persistency, and so on. Really thought, because Grace asked me a question that how you could do something this in practice. And because I have said this, that future of any education system lies in learning analytics. How we could do it? And of course, I mean, and then we got this kind of agreement, because of course in Finland it's called ViLLE, globally it's called Eduten, and of course Makke is here, and we agreed that anybody who, from you, and now I mean research pilot, if you want to do it, you can do it with Eduten. But of course, there is one I want to get the data and do some research on that. But that's the thing, doing what is the impact for your kids, for your pupils. So contact Mark there, then we can go forward. Thank you.